Welcome in to TGI Friday. Thomas Miller on the Fun Astrology Podcast, September 24th. Glad you're here. I got a little cleaning up or addition, not cleaning up, addition to yesterday's. We were answering that question from Kanna about Mars moving into Libra, and all of a sudden it triggered all kinds of relationship issues for her. And we were talking about finding relationships in your chart. You know, that could be any particular area that has been triggered. And astrologers have been pointing to this little stretch right here, the latter part of this week. So the 23rd, 24th, 25th, retrograde, Mercury retrograde starts early Monday morning. I know a lot of astrologers on Astro Twitter have been pointing to this little section of a few days with some trepidation of what might be in store for planet Earth. And basically what they're looking at are a couple of things, and one of them will occur tomorrow, and that is, we've been talking about this big grand trine with Saturn and Mars. Well, that trine happens tomorrow evening, Saturday night, 6 p.m. Eastern time. Now, Mars has been moving into that aspect for, goodness, we've been talking about this thing for, what, a week, I guess. But so, I mean, this is not new energy, but it culminates tomorrow. Often that can be a trigger. The other part of that angst, aside from Mercury getting ready to turn retrograde, is the opposition that we talked about yesterday between Venus and Uranus. Uranus is sitting in Venus's house, Taurus. And today, 12:56 p.m., so just after, almost just shy of 1 o'clock this afternoon, Eastern time, the moon conjuncts Uranus. So there's a little bit of a trigger on top of that little cherry pie of those aspects that a lot of astrologers have been looking at nervously. And then, of course, we're a couple of days past the square between Mercury and Pluto. Now, this has been the look on the favorable side week, so we're going to focus more there. But if you are experiencing some mental turmoil, if you will, that is the shadow side of that aspect, and it is a scratchy aspect. When you say two planets trying to work together, how might they work positively even amidst that square? Well, PMA, positive mental attitude. Also, a very highly connected spiritual communication pipeline to the home office, if you will. Like, it could be on fire if you were on the positive side of that aspect. Now, the keywords are basically reflecting the same thing, because across the board, see, the keywords haven't changed that much all week. Crisis is still up there at the top, crisis and change. I would say that the keywords have a little bit more of a tense overtone today than they did at the beginning of the week, because we have things like nervousness, difficulty, even nervous disorders. So see, there's that Pluto-Mercury theme right there showing up in the keywords. Boom. But we also have joy and love, inspiration, friendship, encounter. And see, that's pretty much what we had at the beginning of the week. I would say at the beginning of the week, we had a few more of the more positive characteristics in the higher strength category. But these are not train wreck keywords like we've seen a couple of times before, right? Now, as we look ahead, that Mars trine Saturn is tomorrow at 6 p.m. Good day for yard work tomorrow. The moon is void, of course, most of the day, 9 o'clock tomorrow until 8:35 tomorrow night, when the moon leaves Taurus and enters Gemini. Sunday has an interesting aspect. Wee hours of the morning at 2:06 a.m., the sun will trine the north node and sextile the south node. So between that Mars trining Saturn, that's big part of that big triangle, that grand trine that we've been talking about, then the sun aspecting the nodes in a positive way is this whole karmic theme just reiterated big time on Sunday. 2:06 a.m. is that one. So yes, we have the Taurus moon today. We have the void, of course, tomorrow with the Mars trining Saturn. The moon then moves into Gemini. That opens up the whole Mercury connection, right? And then the sun hits the nodes. So, I mean, we are really setting this whole weekend up for karmic business. So stuff might come up. And if it does, allow it. Go back and listen to my last couple of Subconscious Mind Mastery podcasts about pulling the Jenga blocks, because this was a great weekend to do that. I mean, great. Now, tomorrow, medical astrology with Stephanie talking about Capricorn, Capricorn moon, Capricorn rising, Capricorn sun, or if you have Capricorn in your chart, come on and listen to us tomorrow. We'll be talking about that. Then Sunday, we got this great question from somebody when we were talking about the rulership of Virgo, and it was a very interesting question that explores things like Ceres, Ophiuchus, some of the dwarf planets, and the constellation that isn't, the 13th zodiac constellation. I don't know, just it's an interesting conversation. You'll have to come join us on Sunday. We're just going to sit and have a chat about some interesting stuff, primarily about what does the consciousness of the future look like from an astrological perspective. That's the real conversation. So have a great TGI Friday, back tomorrow, back Sunday, and then Mercury retrograde on Monday. So we got a busy couple of 3 days. Take care. Have a good Friday. Bye-bye.